I jokingly refer to myself sometimes as 003, which means I've been active at the national level of the conservative movement longer than every living national conservative except for two others. And 002 is Dr. Lee Edwards, senior fellow at the Heritage Foundation, and 001 is the grand lady of the conservative movement, is Phyllis Schlafly, who just recently turned 90 years of age, and Phyllis is going as hard and strong as she ever has. I bump into her regularly at meetings all over the country, and she's just as engaged as she's ever been. And there was a period of time after the Goldwater loss, through the second half of the 60s, through most of the 70s, when we didn't have the leadership that we've got now. And Phyllis was Horatio at the bridge. She was an army of one, almost. And she was our general and our leader that was out there showing us that we could go head-to-head, toe-to-toe with the establishment and beat them. The Equal Rights Amendment never became part of the Constitution because of the leadership of one person, Phyllis Schlafly. And people sometimes think of Phyllis maybe in a too narrow a focus. They think of her as only focused maybe on the Equal Rights Amendment or maybe just family issues, and she's certainly a major leader in the family. Those public policy issues, but she's also exceedingly knowledgeable. She's a lawyer, and she's written extensively about the Supreme Court and the judicial system, and foreign policy is also an area of expertise. She's a Renaissance person, and so she has been an indispensable leader of the conservative movement. The conservative movement may not exist to the level it does today without the leadership of Phyllis Schlafly.